Now, let us look at topicity, and we will now look at what is enantiotopic phases and diastereotopic phases. The first, let us look at enantiotopic phases for the same molecule. If you look at this molecule, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons are there. It is a pentane parent carbon. We have an alcohol. This hydroxyl or the OH is here. Oxygen is here at the top. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons are there. This is the pentane unit. We have a hydroxyl here. And the same, we have the same molecule, exactly the same molecule. I can overlap this with this one. And this is the identical molecule we are talking about. Now we are going to see whether this molecule has enantiotopic and diastereotopic phases. So first, let us look at the enantiotopic phases. I am going to replace this proton which is pointing towards you with a hydroxyl. And in this molecule, again, in the second carbon, I am going to replace the proton with another hydroxyl. If you look at these two molecules, these two are now mirror images of each other. If you see, these two are mirror image, this is again mirror image, this part and the whole molecule is the mirror image of one another. Are they superimposable? I take the molecule and keep it like this. Oxygen is matching, carbon is matching, but here we have an oxygen, but here we have another oxygen. So that means these two are not matching. So that means this is not a superimposable mirror image, but it is the simple mirror image. It is the mirror image, but non-superimposable mirror image. So that means these two are the enantiomeric pairs. So these two are enantiomeric pairs. Now, I will go to another set of enantiotopic replacement. I have replaced the two protons from the front side. Now what I will do, I will replace it from the back side and I will see whether we do get the enantiotopic thing or not. I just replace these two. The same way I replace these two. Now if you look at, again, you have another set of enantiotopic compounds. So these two are mirror images of each other. So either I replace the two protons which are pointing towards the observer, or if I replace the two protons which are pointing away from the observer, I have to replace both from the same side. Remember, then only this is called the enantiotopic one. I can also do the same for this carbon. If I replace the front one with OH, the same way I will have to replace the front one with this OH. So what are we getting? We are again getting another enantiomer. So these two are mirror image of each other. I cannot superimpose one on top of the other. So that means these two are enantiomeric compounds. So this is another set of enantiomeric compounds. Now, on the same carbon, if I replace the front and back, I have to do the same on this carbon. So we have another set of enantiomers. So we have one pair here. When these two are replaced, we had another pair. When these two protons are replaced, we had one set. When these two are replaced, we had another set. So total there are four sets of enantiomeric phases are there on this molecule. Remember, when we say enantiomeric replacement, it is both on the same carbon atom. This is again both on the same carbon atom, whether they are pointing towards the observer or whether they are pointing away from the observer, replacement of those protons leads to enantiomeric pairs.